I am really today very interested in this meeting because it gives me hope. You know, I think that today what we really need is to see how can we really, at this very moment, historical moment, to redress the present trends. And for this, I think that this initiative of the World Academy of Art and Science, of the World University Consortium, of the NSDA, of the International Association of Presidents of University is really very timely, because now the time for action has arrived. We have been during so many decades only spectators of what was happening. Now the universities, in general, the scientific, academic, intellectual, artistic communities, they have a special role. I like very much when Gary Jacobs was already during the last 5 years telling us that what we need is a new kind of leadership. We must now not be only listening and knowing what happens. Now we must come to action. And it is for this that I like very much when it is said that we have a global leadership of higher education for the effective multilateralism and sustainable development. Because now, for the first time in history, I insist, this is feasible. I have been very interested also with the concept notes that have been published. And I must congratulate Gary Jacobs and all those that have been working in the Alberto Zucconi, etc., in the Cadmus paper and in the note, concept note of this meeting that can be as a guidance for all those that are going to participate during these days in this meeting. Now, you have made us a question. You have said, what is the meaning of university today? And I like very much this today, because I have been now more than near 65 years related with universities. And now I realize that today we can act in a way that until now was not feasible. Because 30 years ago, 40 years ago, when President Roosevelt said in the first phrase, that is a wonderful phrase of the United Nations system, he said in the charter, "We the peoples, we the peoples, we have resolved to save the succeeding generations from the scourge of war." It was fantastic. "We the peoples." But the peoples were not existent at this moment, because I remember when I was rector of Granada that I was thinking, who are the persons that are coming and today are able to participate? It was less than 10%, because world, 90% of the peoples, of "we the peoples," were human beings that were being born, living and dying in 40 kilometers square and nothing more, because they have not the possibility of expressing themselves, their views. They were not able to know what was happening at the worldwide level. And particularly, they were always under an absolute, absolute male power. Male power. Women was absolutely excluded of all these possibilities of action. Now, on the contrary, from around 25-30 years ago, now progressively there is no more discrimination. This was terrible. Gender discrimination. Women was always set aside. There was discrimination because of sexual sensitivity, because of ideology, because of the beliefs or the ethnia, color of the skin. Now, and this is very important to tell you the answer today. Now, for the first time, progressively, there is no discrimination anymore, and the women are having the role that they can have, and all the human beings are equal in dignity. I think that this is in the preamble of the UNESCO's constitution, and this is essential. All human beings equal in dignity. Now all human beings equal in dignity now can already act, and they can act together, and they can join their all their efforts for this leadership that Gary Jacobs is recommending to the universities from many years now. And at this respect, I like to repeat concerning what is education, because we are in higher education. And what is education? Because there are many today, many economic institutions that are telling us what is education, but from the point of view of being consumers of other aspects of the economy and the social problems. No, no. What really matters is what is in UNESCO, it is said in the article number one of the Constitution, says, to be educated is to be free and responsible. Today, we need to be free and responsible, because we are not responsible if we do not act. Now we know what must be done. Now we know that there are, and you know this very well, the Agenda 2030 to transform the world. We must change our way of life. You know, I remember that Edgar Morin in France, when he was 100 years old, he said, il faut changeons de voix. And now I told him, changeons de vie. It's not only to change our way of action, we must change also our style of life. We must realize that now the moment is arrived for all the peoples to be responsible and to be acting in favor of this very important sustainable objectives that we must put into practice. As a scientist, I must add that I know very well that irreversible, I have been always against and trying to prevent irreversible situations. It's terrible to say this has no remedy anymore. Therefore, now for the first time in history, we have global threats that are irreversible. But at the same time, we have the possibility of working all together, women, men, everybody, because all of us were equal in dignity. And also for the first time, and this in part because of the digital technology, we can express ourselves. We can participate. We can therefore participate in the democratic multilateralism. We can now tell all these people that during the last decades has been with the G6, G7, G8, with a neoliberal plutocratic governance that has been absolutely malicious for the humanity as a whole. Now we have the possibility of telling them, now, yes, now we can say, we the peoples, because now we the peoples, we can exist and we can act and we can react. And at the same time, we can participate. It's for this that I consider that consultation that you have done to us, saying what is the meaning of the university today, is to say the universities as the communities, the intellectual communities, is to say there is a hope, because every human being is able to create, is able to think, is able to imagine, is able to innovate, is able to create. We have a creator in all human beings. Therefore, what we must do is to be able to realize that we have this immense potential, that now we can participate, we can create a new future. And I think that the universities, the communities, artistic, intellectual, etc., must have the leadership at this respect.